This is game three between the Prussian Prince of the Agony Clan and Llewelin of Agartha. Since it worked so well, bringing no infantry against Llewelin in the first battle, the Prussian Prince is going to try it again, but this time with Epirus. And there are several problems with this. One is that you don't have any cataphracts. You have Hellenic Royal Cavalry. And while they are good show cavalry, they are not Eastern cataphracts. The Thessalians are good show cavalry. They don't have they don't have as big a charge bonus as the Persian cavalry has, I believe. I believe the Persian cavalry has 76 charge bonus. They might have 67, but I believe it's 76. And the mercenary Cretan archers are very good, but they are so expensive. The archers only have 125 range. That difference is massive. So, although the Prussian prince has brought, let's see here, he has 4 archers, 3 mercenary Rhodian slingers, 5 archers, and 1 mercenary Cretan archer, this type of build is not as strong as the Eastern skirmish builds, because they lack cataphracts, because they lack horse archers. Tarentines cannot be used as horse archers, and they have less range on the archers, and they don't have 6 slingers, and 6 slingers is massively important for the extra ammunition and for the extra armor penetration. But he is up against the Lusitani, and the Lusitani are strong in close combat, but they don't have a lot of armor. However, the Scutari spears have a very nice bonus, a very nice chance to block incoming missiles of 50%. Then he has 6 veteran shield warriors, very strong units. He has 5 units of Scutari cavalry, 1 unit of Iberian cavalry, no skirmishers in this battle either. So it's going to be interesting to see if he can make this work. The Iberian cavalry is very fast, so it might be able to get in quickly. The Scutari cavalry is medium melee cavalry, while the heavy horse is heavy melee cavalry, I believe. So the Scutari cavalry is faster. It should be able to catch the skirmishers easier than the heavy horse does. And Llewelin is not going to make the same mistake twice. He's not going to waste his cavalry. He's just going to use his infantry to screen against the skirmishers, and then he's going to keep pushing forward and try to get his cavalry in. But let's see here. We should see shock cavalry charges incoming fairly soon. The problem is that if the shock cavalry just charges into infantry and there is no response from the cavalry, it's going to be near impossible for the Prussian prince to defend his skirmishers. So the score is 1-1 with the Prussian prince and Llewelin. The Prussian prince has to win this to advance to the next round of the tournament. So does Llewelin. So there's a lot at stake here. The Thessalian cavalry incoming against Scutari cavalry, but the spear support is so close, they're able to throw javelins right into the Thessalians. And he's firing into, doing the same thing he did in the previous battle, but now he's firing into his own shock cavalry and doing a lot of damage to them. They're getting attacked in the rear when they are riding out here. So while he did manage to take care of this unit of Scutari, his Thessalians are going to take so much damage from the Scutari spearmen in prolonged melee. And already the Scutari cavalry of Llewelin is going to run in here and absolutely destroy these archer units. So already this is not looking good for the Prussian prince. These archer units are going to get destroyed. We have Tarentines moving in, doing damage to the Scutari cavalry. Scutari spearmen running after here, but he's just losing cavalry and skirmishers so fast in this battle. It's going to be very, very difficult to kill the rest of what Lusitani has with what he has left now. He's not pulling away his mercenary Rhodians. They are firing into the Scutari spearmen, but it's not really effective. Miss micros his Thessalians to a massive degree here. Does not get the charges. They're getting charged by Scutari spearmen. And getting into these cavalry units here was massive for Llewelin, who was able to take down a lot of Scutari. And here come the very fast Iberian cavalry, able to ride in and absolutely wreck these mercenary Rhodian slingers. They're attacked in the rear, and units of the cavalry units of the Prussian prince are just being destroyed so quickly by the Lusitani infantry and cavalry. Sending in his Hellenic Royal Guard to try to stop the units for a while, but he is going to get charged here by, the Iberian swords could fire. Looks like he's going to pull them out and start firing, but on all edges of the map, the cavalry units of the Prussian prince are being destroyed. His skirmishers are quickly becoming destroyed as well. He does not have the cavalry to stop the Lusitani cavalry. He doesn't have the horse skirmishers to be able to do the damage he needs to do against the Iberian cavalry. And he's just going to keep getting pushed back here by Llewelin. Very nicely done here by Llewelin in getting his cavalry to deal with the cavalry of Epirus, while also taking care of the skirmishers. So like I said, the build that the Prussian prince brought in the first battle and the way he executed that battle was perfect as a first battle. But an opponent like Llewelin is not going to make the same mistake twice. So he conserved his cavalry better here. He did not go for the enemy cavalry. Went straight for the skirmishers. And when he does that and the infantry is in close support, it's going to be just impossible for the Prussian prince to make it work. No way to do it, even against the Lusitani. So bringing this Epirus build was super risky by the Prussian prince, I think. Especially since he pulled that one off on Nemetusana before. I think it would have been a lot safer to go for a more standard build. Maybe some pikes, skirmishers, cavalry support, hold down the center, do a lot of damage with the skirmishers, try to snipe the general, standard tactics against barbarians. So the skirmish build is quickly getting destroyed here. The Tarentines desperately trying to stop the Lusitani advance. Charging into Scutari spears and veteran shield warriors. But although they're able to knock down some of them, Tarentine cavalry is horrible in melee. And I know some people think they are okay, but let's just pause it here to have a look at their stats. They have 18 melee attack, 24 weapon damage, and an 11 charge bonus. The only thing that's good about Tarentine cavalry is that they have 60 armor, but other than that, they're good at countering elephants, but that's about it. They are not comparable to the raiding horse and the Galatian raiders, for example. They are much worse units in melee. Scutari cavalry defeating mercenary Italian cavalry with support by Iberian swords. Not a whole lot the Prussian prince can do at this point. He's just being chased all across the map. Javelins incoming from all sides against his Tarentine cavalry. And he's pushed to the edge of the map. There's still cavalry left alive on the field for Llewelin. Scutari spears getting charged by Thessalians. They should get wrecked. Yep, absolutely wrecked. But just not enough Epirus to deal with what Lusitani has left on the field here. Another charge from depleted cavalry units, but Llewelin keeps his guerrillas in close support, and they're able to throw a lot of javelins in against the Hellenic Royal Cavalry, taking down a significant amount of them, and the Lusitani nobles haven't taken any damage yet. The archers are being surrounded. Charged by Iberian swords. And there is nowhere for the Prussian prince to run here, nowhere to hide. His army is going to start chain routing pretty soon. Very nice kills on this unit of Thessalians. Decent amount of kills on the other units, but nothing great. And the main problem here is the lack of range on the skirmishers and the lack of good solid cavalry units that can blob up the enemy and do a lot of damage to the cavalry in the process. The Epirus cavalry does not have the staying power the Eastern cavalry has, and lacking horse archers is also a massive problem. Tarentines are routing off the field. The Prussian prince is out of the tournament. Llewelin managed to defeat him. 2 against 1. and the skirmishers here were super ineffective. He brought 11 cavalry units and 9 skirmishers again, but against a player that has come up against it and knows how to counter it, it's going to be very hard to make it work, because the Scutari cavalry and the Iberian cavalry went straight for the skirmishers, and without skirmishing support, these cavalry units are going to struggle massively against even the Lusitani. So very interesting series of battles here. Llewelin advances to the next round in the tournament, and the Prussian prince is out, but he did put on a great show. Thanks for watching. Strength and honor.